Welcome again to Terry Talks, the number one talk show of all time. Joining me today is Kiel Kuntvinsky, a rising star amongst the progressive wing within the Democratic Party. Thank you for joining me, Kiel.
My pleasure, Terry. Happy to be here.
So, things seem to be finalizing with the Democratic primaries.
Indeed they are, Terry.
What is your take on who will ultimately win the nomination?
Well, Terry, a week ago I would have told you that it's not even going to be a question. Bernie's got this.
And now?
Well, we have to take into account how the establishment has finally coalesced around their candidate.
You mean Senator Biden?
Yes. Somehow they've managed to do the impossible, which is pick a worse candidate than Hillary.
I see. It indeed seems that earlier predictions from the mainstream media indicating that Mr. Sanders will have a tough fight gaining support from moderate voters was correct.
What? No, the mainstream media is never right about anything, Terry.
Interesting. On Twitter, you were one of many progressives that posted screenshots of a graphic which displayed Mr. Sanders' polling numbers up against the remaining moderate candidates.
Yeah. It was so stupid. Bernie was in the lead by far. So in order to sway public opinion back the other way, the establishment was basically trying to say, yeah, Bernie's way behind if you just add up all the poll numbers from every other candidate.
Considering what has recently transpired, were they not correct?
Well, that's not the point. The point is that the DNC is actively conspiring to shut down a Democratic candidate because they disagree with his politics.
I agree that the DNC has taken steps that can, in my view, be perceived as nefarious.
Right.
However, do you not think they are at least a little justified in their defensive actions?
No! That's the whole point. They are cheating to beat Bernie just like they did in 2016.
Senator Sanders was a registered independent before running in 2016, was he not?
And?
He speaks of revolution and turning the party on its head.
So?
You yourself, along with former congressional candidate Chuck Yeager, created a political group, the Justice Democrats, with the intended and widely stated goal of infiltrating and ultimately taking over the party.
I see what you're getting at, Terry, but the thing is, we want to take over through the voters. Through the will of the people. Not underhanded tactics like trying to sway public opinion by framing Bernie as behind or the technical loser when he won three states. And he did win three states. Don't get me started on Iowa.
I do agree that what happened in Iowa did appear deeply suspect. Also, what was done in order to put Mike Bloomberg on the debate stage was very questionable.
Questionable? It was cheating. Otherwise, they would let Tulsi on the debate stage. They changed the rules to let Bloomberg on, and to keep any progressive off.
Yes. I agree it was unfair. However, they are a private political party created by people with specific beliefs. Should they not defend themselves?
Not. By. Cheating.
And you consider the moderate candidates dropping out and endorsing Senator Biden to be unfair?
Totally underhanded and unfair.
How so?
Because they were ordered to buy the DNC. I even heard President Obama was the one who made the calls.
Surely it is not against the rules or underhanded to endorse a candidate whose policies and ideology are more in line with your own.
But they did it right before Super Tuesday. It was coordinated. They didn't even try to hide it.
I agree it was a bold strategy. But that still would not fit the criteria of cheating, would it?
It does in my book.
So you co-founded a group with the sole purpose of defeating the moderate politicians of the DNC, and when those moderates join together in order to remain in power, they are cheating.
They cheated with Hillary, and they are cheating with Biden now.
While I can agree that there have been several questionable acts taken by the DNC in order to defeat Senator Sanders, I do not believe Senator Biden receiving more support from moderate voters because the other moderate candidates dropped out is cheating or nefarious in any way.
Well, we disagree.
Yes, that's unfortunate. Speaking of moderate voters, do you have any insight on how Senator Sanders plans to gain their support over Senator Biden?
It's gonna be tough, man. I used to think it would be easy, but with all of the media against us and spreading lies and misinformation about Bernie and his policies, this race just got real.
And that, in your opinion, is the only reason why the pathway to the nomination will be difficult? Because of misinformation from the media?
Well, duh, because everyone already agrees with our policies.
Really?
Totally, man. The polls show even a majority of Republicans support some of our policies. That's not my opinion, that's a fact.
I find that to be quite astonishing, if not hard to believe.
It's all about the framing, Terry. If people were polled the correct way, Bernie would have been elected decades ago.
I see. So the moderate independent voters and Republican voters agree with Senator Sanders on his policies?
Mostly.
Then why did the moderate voters overwhelmingly support Senator Biden last Tuesday?
Partly because Elizabeth Warren hadn't dropped out yet. But like I said, it's mostly because of the lies in the media.
There is no chance that moderate voters just simply disagree with Senator Sanders' policies and ideology.
What? No. They're just being lied to.
That is, a somewhat large portion of the voting population they claim are misinformed.
Well, they are.
And what, if I may ask, about your co-founding partner for the Justice Democrats, Mr. Chuck Hugo?
What about him?
Did he not lose his congressional race by a substantial margin to his more moderate opponent?
We can't expect to win them all. The media was lying about Chuck too, and it was a purple district.
I did notice one instance where the media deliberately misrepresented Mr. Hugo's position concerning David Duke.
Right? It was reprehensible. They are scared of us. Combine that with a purple district, and you've got an almost impossible fight on your hands.
Mr. Hugo said, quite confidently, that he would prove a progressive candidate can easily win purple districts.
The media lies, man.
Do you predict Senator Sanders will regain the delegate lead?
Totally.
I suppose we will find out next Tuesday.
Yeah. Sure will.